Hello viewers! Is your car using too much engine oil and you have to put in a quart every couple of thousand miles? While all engines do consume some small amount of oil between oil changes, this is definitely too much and indicates something's wrong. Even more, besides being annoying and financially burdensome, excessive oil consumption can cause additional damage in the long run. And because that's something you surely want to avoid, let's see what might cause your car to use too much oil. The engine in any car can lose oil for two main reasons. Either it's burning during the combustion process or it's leaking out. Now let's start with leaks, as finding them is usually easier and they are cheaper to fix. Basically, if the engine is leaking oil, especially if this is substantial, you'll probably spot a greasy puddle underneath it when parked on the driveway. If so, pop the hood and try to track where it's coming from, starting from the bottom of the engine and working your way up until you reveal the leak's origin. The area where the leak is will be all covered with oil and dirt, so you'll have to clean this up with a rag and a brake cleaner or similar detergent. Still, finding the leak can sometimes be quite difficult, given how cramped the engine bays in your cars are, so if you're unable to find where the leak is coming from, it might be a good idea to have it checked by an experienced mechanic. Some common places where the oil might leak include a valve cover gasket, oil filter housing, crankshaft and camshaft seals, and oil pan gasket. And also, I'd mention the oil cooler here, which might crack, allowing the oil to escape into the cooling system. You can tell if that's the case by checking the coolant bottle, which will be filled with a whitish goo instead of clear coolant, although this can also mean the head gasket is cracked. We have a separate video on this issue, so make sure to watch it if you're having something like that. The other possible scenario is that the oil is somehow entering the cylinders where it gets burned during the combustion process. This, if severe enough, will cause puffs of bluish smoke coming from the exhaust, and when and how this happens can help determine the cause. So let's see what's possible here. If you're lucky, your car might be burning oil because of something as simple as a bad PCV valve, which regulates how much oily fumes are going from the engine's crankcase to the intake. If this valve is broken, the flow will be too excessive, especially while idling or on full throttle, resulting in clouds of white blue smokes in such situations. Besides the PCV valve, the crankcase ventilation system has several hoses and pipes that connect it to the engine's intake. With time, the oil fumes may clog the system, especially if the car is often driven over short distances. This causes a pressure buildup inside the crankcase, forcing the oil into the combustion chamber where it gets burned while the engine is running. Then, inside the cylinder head, we have the valve seals, which are small sealing rings that sit at the top of the valve stem, preventing the oil from leaking downward and into the cylinders. And that's exactly what's going to happen if they are worn, causing puffs of blue smoke on startup or when pressing the throttle after the car's been idling for a minute or two. Next, if we were to dig a bit deeper inside the engine, we'd find the pistons with several rings on them, whose job is to create a seal against the cylinder walls, ultimately allowing the engine to efficiently compress the gases. But if the piston rings or the cylinder walls are worn out, there will be a gap between them, through which the oil enters the combustion chamber while the expanding gases escape into the crankcase. Besides high oil consumption and blue smoke that appears during hard accelerations, this will also affect the engine's performance and overall drivability. Most cars with diesel engines, as well as some newer gasoline-powered ones, have a turbocharger, which uses engine oil to lubricate its moving parts. If the seals inside it are bad, the oil will leak into the intake or exhaust, generating substantial amounts of blue smoke, most prominently just after the startup. Such defective turbocharger can cause extremely high oil consumption, especially at highway speeds, and may even result in an engine runaway in diesel-powered vehicles. On the other hand, the whole issue might be caused by something as simple as using the wrong or poor quality oil. For instance, If the motor oil you use has bad heat resistance, it might not be able to cope with the temperature your engine is running at. In simple words, it will start breaking apart at a molecular level and evaporating once it's fully warmed up. Not only does this result in high oil consumption, but it also generates carbon buildup in the engine. A similar will happen if you're using too thin engine oil, as it'll slip by the piston rings and valve seals and into the combustion chamber. That's why it's essential to use the exact oil type recommended by the auto manufacturer, and the information on this can be found in the owner's manual. Lastly, we have the oil pressure, which needs to be at a certain level to ensure adequate engine protection. However, if there is a clog somewhere, it can lead to increased oil pressure, which can turn into faster consumption. For example, your car may have a clogged oil filter. Changing it will help the oil flow normally again, and it will also ensure better engine temperature. If your car is burning more oil than it should, there are a few different methods for fixing it. The first and easiest step is to check the oil quality. Reference the type of oil you are using and match it up with what's recommended by the manufacturer. If you aren't using the right viscosity or type, it's time to change the oil and filter. You may also choose to upgrade to a better brand than what you're currently using. If you check the oil and it looks dirty and contaminated, go ahead and change it. From here, keep track on how often you are adding more oil to get a better idea on what's going on. The next step is a little harder, especially since you're dealing with internal engine components, as it's time to figure out which one of them is bad so it can be fixed. Some issues aren't difficult to resolve, such as replacing a PCV valve. Other issues aren't as easy to determine, such as if the engine has bad valve seals. To get to the bottom of the problem, you may need to look at all the symptoms the vehicle is experiencing and then put all this information together like a puzzle. Many of these problems aren't for novices, so if you're only accustomed to changing the oil and performing other basic tasks, it's better for you to take the car to an experienced mechanic. Excessive oil consumption in most cases won't have a noticeable and immediate effect on the engine's operation, so you might be tempted to just drive it like that. This, however, isn't a good idea because the oil entering the combustion chamber will foul the spark plugs, generate carbon buildups inside the engine, and even worse, damage the expensive catalytic converter. Also, with the engine oil continuously dropping, there is always a danger of it becoming too low, which can lead to serious and expensive damage. And lastly, all the oil your car burns increases its emissions, making it more harmful to the environment. In the end, what we want to know is how much will it cost to repair the high oil consumption, and that depends on what's causing it. If it's something as simple as changing the oil or replacing a bad PCV valve, it probably won't be more than $100. Things like a leaking turbocharger or valve seals, though, are far more pricier and you might pay several thousand dollars to fix it. And it's even worse if the piston rings are worn, as this calls for a complete engine overhaul or replacement, which might not even be feasible on an older car. So, these are some of the most common causes of high oil consumptions and the ways to deal with it. I hope this video was helpful, and if so, don't forget to hit that like button and share it with your friends. On the other hand, if you're having some different engine issues, be sure to check other videos here or visit our site, mechanicbase.com, for detailed automotive repair guides. Bye!